What's up, man? What's your name, brother?
You know, I've been out there on the streets, but every time I started from square one, it was because something I did. It was my fault. Either, you know, drug use getting out of control, mm-hmm. or getting in trouble and going to jail. Okay. And this time, the unfortunate part about it is that's disheartening to me is that I finally was stable for 2 years, mm-hmm. working every day, doing the right thing, and my house catches on fire.
Wow.
You know, and the fire didn't damage it that bad. It was still livable. The fire department messed it up even more. What? I tried to go back in the house. Neighbor called the cops. Cops came, said you can't live here.
And what?
Here I am out in the street. But I bounced back quick. You know, I do roofing, siding, flooring, and I also climb trees. I do tree work.
But how are you surviving right now?
I'm working. Unfortunately, it's not as much as I'd like to be working, mm-hmm. but I'll bounce back and I'll make it. Another couple of weeks, I should be all right.
How about your family?
Rough, but
ain't nobody helping you? Your family? Nobody?
No, I left my house when I was 14. I don't have any family in this state. My mother and father are in Georgia. My brothers are in Pennsylvania, and my other family's scattered about.
So you're not from New York?
No, I'm from Brooklyn.
Okay. Brooklyn in the house?
Yeah.
East New York, Brownsville?
That's exactly where I'm from. I was born in Coney Island, raised
Coney
in East
Island,
New York.
Oh, man.
Bedford-Stuyvesant. I've moved around the whole borough, the whole city. Lived in Long Island for a little bit, you know?
God bless
I got
you,
around
man.
Quite a bit.
Well, what's your name?
My name is Paul.
Nice to meet you, Paul.
How I got to Rochester, mm-hmm. it's a funny story. I was in a town called Bayshore, Long Island.
What's this?
And,
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And, I was behind the strip mall after work, mm-hmm. Actually selling weed. It's a funny story. And I see this guy coming around, and I thought he was a cop. And then I seen the tools in his truck one day, and I seen the license plate. It said, Burdick Ford from mm-hmm. Rochester.
Okay.
So, I told him he couldn't get any weed unless he gave me a job, and he was doing commercial tile and stone, and I lied about my age, and it was history from then, you know.
How many years?
Oh, shit, I was 15 when I met him. It was 2 weeks before my 15th birthday, and it's funny because I came to Rochester 4 years ago this time. And I stayed for good. I met a girl named Brandy. I wanted to be with her for the rest of my life. Things didn't work out too well. It was very unfortunate.
So nobody helps you out right now? Nobody?
No, just me, bud.
All
just
right, me. Man.
You know, I'll be all right. I mean, I like to help people. You know, that's what I do. And when I'm in a position where I can't help other people, it bothers me. So that motivates me to get back on my feet, because there are a lot of good people out here that do need help.
You go to church at all?
Do I do drugs?
No, go to church.
Oh, go to church. No, I haven't for a while. For a while. Right now, I am clean. I am not using.
Okay, cool.
I did relapse when I went through my breakup with my girlfriend. And I got over it. I stopped. I put my foot down. I stopped drinking. I was an alcoholic since I was about 15, 16 years old, and over the summer, I just picked up a beer, took a sip, put it down, and didn't want it anymore. Quit drinking.
Right, man. Well, God bless you today, man. I'm going to bless you with some money today, okay?
Thank you. Yes, sir.
All right, cool.